we need to encourage organisations that think that there is no money, and I think the credit crunch will hit the public sector, I think, a year 18 months' time. And I know actually how to cut services a lot better than I do spend. Where I work in my day job, we have lots of money, and it's very difficult to actually spend money, believe it or not. So I'm very experienced at cutting services, because that's what I've spent most of my NHS on. But we need to start working with our NHS organisations to actually say these MCAs, laptops, aren't a luxury. They are a necessity to enable us to care for our patients safely. I was talking with a GP colleague a few weeks ago who actually said to me that, Bob, she said, it's really quite interesting because doing my home visits now, I'm actually at risk. Because when I could take my Lloyd George notes out with me, I had a complete history of what's happening with the patient. Now when I go on a home visit, I get a printout of the last few visits, but I don't get all the detail of what's happened at the hospital, etc. And he said it's actually becoming quite serious how we do that. He needs an MCA, doesn't he? He needs to be able to actually link into his practice off-site so he's got the patient's complete history. So as much as we're advancing with this, there are some practicalities in our clinical work we need to start asking and demanding that this is an important tool to enable us to do our work. We wouldn't dream of going to see a patient now without some sort of blood pressure monitoring machine. You wouldn't take the old-fashioned sphygmomanometer and just wait for the mental case. You don't do that anymore. I expect some do, but certainly we don't. And most places I go to, they don't do that. So we actually need to look at how we move with this. And the other thing that worries me with this is that it's a bit like when you buy your mobile phone, it's out of date, isn't it? They've brought out a new model. And I think with all of this, because it's nearly at the start of this, it's at the infancy of its life, these will continually evolve. And as we as users start to actually feedback, well, this was a bit wrong, it didn't quite say how it should have on the tin, you need to do it this way. And also advances in medicine and treatment has changed, we need you to do this. So it will evolve. There's got to be some way of replacing these rather than saying this is what you're using in 10 years' time and it will be what we'll see in a museum. I often say that, I mean, I've got twin grandsons of about 3 and a half and they've got a fish and fry stand on and they use it when they go to play, go to work, and it's quite sweet. But for people coming up now, technology will be so much more advanced. And what we're using today, they're in there, so you've got children of their own, they will see some of this in museums, won't they, like we do there, or I do, I go and think, I don't have that as a chance to be in a museum, I'm not that old. And I think we have to think of how we do that. But there has to be some way in the NHS that we get that continual replacement so we're not forever playing catch-up. I mean, again, the community, we have fixed computer between 8 nurses, and then people wonder why their records are not up to date. When they go to court because if something's happened or they're about, you know, and or the nursing industry council to query whether they need to be struck off, it won't matter if the IT works or not. It will be the nurse having to defend the decision of what they did, or the GP or a medical practitioner in the hospital through their the general medical. And I think we owe it to them to give the equipment, which is why I'm striving to ensure that the department gives some leadership about making this a reality. I don't want to